this, the second of three special programmes, we will be featuring the posthumous presentation of Stewart Watson's MBE to his wife Jean by the Lord Provost Margaret Farquhar. But first...
Thank you. most wonderful things about the Bonneville Silver Band is its family atmosphere. There are, apart from a lot of Watsons connected with the band, there are a lot of husbands and wives, boyfriends, girlfriends, brothers, sisters, and so on. And the family has always played a very important part, and that has to no small extent been due not only to Stewart but to Jean as well. They have encouraged the family atmosphere and have welcomed the band always into their home. In fact, we were discussing on Thursday evening at a little meeting that we had that probably Watson Street on Hogmanay was the forerunner to the Union Terrace Gardens and Castlegate, because I'm sure there were, if not more, certainly almost as many people used to gather at Watson Street as there were in the Castlegate and in the Union Terrace Gardens to celebrate Aberdeen's Hogmanay. The Watson family are all very musical, and we're going to hear from one of them now. We're going to hear from Neil, who is the principal euphonium in the band, and he's going to play for us, along with the band, the very beautiful arrangement by Roy Newsom of Dublin's Fair City, Neil Watson. guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's at this time that we move on to a very special part of the programme. You will all be aware that in June of last year, Stewart Watson was honoured by Her Majesty the Queen with an MBE in the birthday honours list. However, as we are all too painfully aware, it didn't prove possible for Stewart to receive the award from Her Majesty. In accordance with normal procedures, however, arrangements were made for the award to be made posthumously to Mrs. Jean Watson, and I hereby call on Lord Lieutenant Margaret Farquhar to officiate on behalf of Her Majesty. Ladies and gentlemen, the Lord Lieutenant of the City.
Watson, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, before I move to my official duties here tonight, may I just take this opportunity to say how impressed I am by this marvellous concert. I am sure no greater tribute could be paid to Stewart Watson than the outstanding performance we have heard this evening. Many of you will know that Stewart Watson was last year awarded the MBE in Her Majesty the Queen's birthday honours list. Very sadly, he died before he could be presented with his insignia. As Lord Lieutenant of Aberdeen, I have been called upon to make the presentation this evening to his widow, Mrs. Jean Watson, a duty I am proud and honoured to fulfil. Before I do so, I would like to pay my own tribute to Stewart Watson and say a few words about his many achievements. Music was Stewart Watson's life. From the age of 12, when he first began playing in his local boys' brigade band, until his death last summer, he was actively involved in music making and the brass band movement. Stewart began his career as a grocer, but realizing that music was his true vocation, he set about gaining the necessary qualifications to become a conductor. As soon as he completed his course, he was appointed conductor of his beloved Boys Brigade Band, a position he held throughout his working life. One of his most memorable occasions with the band was in 1958, when the Boys Brigade Council visited Balmoral Castle. Stewart was Aberdeen's first ever school's brass instructor, and for over 30 years, he passed on his love of music to countless boys and girls in the city, many of whom went on to play in local brass bands as a result of his skilled and enthusiastic teaching. Others developed a lifelong appreciation of music and of brass music in particular. He was a tutor, then director of the National Youth Brass Band of Scotland, chairman of the National Association of Brass Band Conductors, and a very much sought after contest adjudicator. These responsibilities would constitute an onerous enough workload for most people, but not apparently for Stewart. In 1962, he helped found the Bonacord Silver Band, and led it through over 30 years of success and national acclaim. Under his direction, the band became one of the best in Scotland, winning countless awards, gaining national recognition, including the 1983 British Brass Band Championships in the Royal Albert Hall, and taking part in numerous television and radio broadcasts. But Stewart always ensured that the band's main efforts were concentrated in the local community, performing at fundraising events, at churches, in public spaces around the city, and in support of local charities. Stewart Watson had a great talent and used it for the benefit of others. His commitment to public service, expressed through his unstinting work in schools, with the Boys Brigade, and with the Bonnycourt Silver Band, as well as through his many other responsibilities, was truly exceptional. His tremendous dedication was an inspiration to us all. Ladies and gentlemen, Stewart Watson was our most deserving and worthy recipient of the MBE, and I am extremely proud and privileged to present his insignia now to Mrs. Jean Watson.
Feature the Czech presentation to the National Youth Brass Band of Scotland and also the massed band performance. But we begin with the Bonacord Silver Band as they play In Memoriam from Royal Parks, which is dedicated to the bandsmen who were victims of the IRA Hyde Park bombing of 1982.
Thank you.
official programme. But of course, as you all know, when you were at Stewart's concert, the official programme never actually was the end of anything. But the last piece they're going to play is called We Are the Reason, and it brought back to mind a faux pas which I made a long, long time ago, when I just not long started teaching in Old Aberdeen School, and Stewart was working with the school brass band, and the headmaster of Old Aberdeen at that time, a chap called Alistair Urquhart, who went on to be head at Kilcorth Academy and is now retired. He seemed to think that the band was doing particularly well, and at the prize giving that year, he had invited John Dalby, who was the music superintendent, to come along and present the prizes to the boys and girls who were the prize winners at Old Aberdeen. And the band were playing, of course. I think it was probably Hindrish's first band book, This Old Man and Eudoxia. That's what the pilot said to the ship's captain, by the way. That's another old Stewart Watson one, Eudoxia. It was an old hymn tune, which would only mean anything to people who played from Hindrish and First Band. But during the introductions, and even in those old days, I talked a lot as well, and I was allowed to introduce the pieces that the band were playing. And I said that while the instruments had all been bought through the good graces of Mr. Dalby, Mr. Watson was responsible for all the pupils. Didn't actually mean that. What I meant was he was responsible for teaching all the pupils. I have to say the audience were a lot better behaved than you. I didn't pick it up like that at all. It was only afterwards that I was pointed out that he did have a like when he was a grocer, but he didn't use the mic for that particular purpose. Stewart had so many little quirks and things. The one I remember vividly, the first or second week that he was with me in Brotherson and I moved there, we had a band practice at lunchtime, which was quite a new innovation because the band at Brotherson used to meet at 8 o'clock in the morning, didn't it? Yeah. People like Eddie Paley used to trundle along Holborn Street at 7:30 in the morning carrying their tuba for a lesson. And look at him now. You ever regretted it? No. The band had, because I don't get up as early in the morning as Jimmy Reith and Stewart Watson, the band had proceeded to a more normal time of 1 o'clock. And Stewart was in the music room early that particular day, and he had a tack and a hammer, and he was hammering this tack into the blackboard. And it was a black tack, and you couldn't see it. And then I said to him, what are you doing? He said, just wait. And then the kids began to come in, and they came in, and Stewart came back, took his jacket off, went across, picked up a piece of chalk, and on the blackboard, drew a little hook, took his jacket off, and hung it up. Nobody was any the wiser except Stewart and I, because we'd been there when it happened. It was little things like that that endeared Stewart to the thousands of children and the hundreds and hundreds of teachers who have had the privilege and pleasure of working with him over the years when he was employed by the city. He is the reason we are here, ladies and gentlemen, and he is the reason for the Bonnycourt Silver Band.